Good morning, students. Hope you are all safe and fine. Today we will talk about the chapter 3. The name of the chapter 3 is trigonometric function. You all are familiar about the term trigonometry because you have already got these things in your HSLC course. Trigonometry is derived from the three Greek word tri means three, gonia means angle, and metron means measurement. That is the measurement of three angles is known as your trigonometry. Now you see, trigonometry is a branch of mathematics where we deals with the angles. And next term is your function. In chapter 2, we have already discussed what is your function and some types of function. Functions are nothing but a special type of a relation. In this chapter, we will discuss about the trigonometric functions. This chapter contains the following subtopics. There are so many subtopics, but today in this video we will discuss only these 5 subtopics. Let's see what are those subtopics. First one is our angles in trigonometry. Second one is measure of an angle. Third one is trigonometric function. Fourth one is sine of trigonometric function. And fifth one is domain and range of the trigonometric function. But in this video we will discuss about the domain. Range of a trigonometric function will be discussed in your later videos, right? Let's start. First, you see the angles in trigonometry. Let's see what is the term means angle. You have already got in your 6th and 7th standard, that is when a line cuts each other or when a line touches each other, then the angle is formed. Now you see, these are your geometrical angle. Whatever we have got in your class 6th or 7th standard, these are nothing but the geometrical angle. That is, when a line cuts each other or touches each other, then the angle which is formed is known as your geometric angle. Now you see, then what is your trigonometrical angle? Are they equal? No, they are not same. Trigonometrical angle means if a ray rotates, then the angle which is formed is known as your trigonometrical angle. Now see, I hope you all know what is a ray, right? If we rotate a ray by keeping one end fixed, if we rotate, then the angle which is formed is known as your trigonometrical angle. Now you see, if we rotate a ray in the anticlockwise direction, then the angle which is formed, we will call this as a positive angle. And if we rotate the ray in a clockwise direction, then the angle which is formed is known as a negative angle. Right? So this is the basic difference between a negative angle and a positive angle. Now if a ray OA in this diagram, I have shown the ray OA is rotated in the anticlockwise direction and it comes to the position OB. So here positive angle is formed, right? Positive angle means that is, it is in the anticlockwise direction. Since here OA is your initial side, by initial line, and the final position is your OB. OB is nothing but your terminal side, right? And if we rotate in our next diagram, if we have rotated the ray OA in the clockwise direction, so we will get here negative angle. Our new position of OA is nothing but your OC, right? So OC is your terminal side and OA is our initial side. So this is the basic difference between the geometrical angle and the trigonometric angle. Our next subtopic is measure of an angle, right? We all know what is a angle. Then next one is measure of an angle. Now you see, in general we have three measurements of an angle, that is degree measure, grade measure, and radian measure. But in your course we have discussed only the degree measure and radian measure. Achha, let's see what is your degree measure. The angle formed is said to have of measure of 1 degree if the rotation of the revolving ray is 1 by 360th of the complete revolution. Then the angle which, if we rotate a revolving ray to 1 by 360th of the complete revolution, then the angle which is formed is known as your 1 degree. And what is your complete angle? Complete revolution means 360 degree. That is, one part of 360 is known as your, then the angle which is formed is known as your 1 degree. And it is denoted by 1 to the power 0. And if we divide 1 degree into 60 equal parts, then each part is known as your 1 minute. That is, 1 degree equal to 60 minute. Now, if we divide each minute into 60 equal parts, then each part is known as a second, right? So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Next one is our radian measurement. In radian measurement says that it is the angle subtended at the center of an unit circle. You all know what is a circle, you all know what is a center. Unit circle means if we draw a circle whose radius is 1, of length 1, this is nothing but your unit circle. Then the angle formed at the center by an arc of an unit circle by an arc of length 1 unit. If we consider, you also know what is an arc of the circle. If we consider an arc length of 1 unit means 1 millimeter, 1 centimeter in that way, then this arc will form a angle at the center. This angle is nothing but your 1 radian, which is denoted by 1 to the power c, and twice pi radian is nothing but your 4 right angles, right? So these are the degree measurement and these are the radian measurement. Now you see here, if one measurement is known to us, we can convert, we can find out the other types of measurement. There is in our next slide, we'll see how we can relate these two measures. So this is the relation between degree measurement and then radian measurement. If d is the measurement of an angle in degree and r is the measurement of the same angle in radian, then the relation between these two are d by 180 equal to r by pi. Let's see the proof of that relation. We also know, we all know that is 90 degree equal to 1 right angle. Therefore, d degree equal to d by 90 right angles. And pi radian is nothing but your 2 right angles. So r radian is r by pi by 2 right angles. So these are the measurement of same angle in degree as well as radian. So we can write d by 90 equal to r by pi by 2. By simplification, we will get d by 180 equal to r by pi. So if degree measurement is known to us, with the help of this relation, we can find out the radian measurement. And if radian measurement is known to us, with the help of this relation, we can find the degree measurement. Let's see how we can find it. Convert the angle 75 degree in radian measurement. That is, here d is given to us, we have to find the value of r. So in this relation, d by 180 equal to r by pi, if we put the value of d, that is 75, and on simplification we will get r is equal to 5 pi by 2 radian. Similarly, in our next question, I hope you can do it. That is, convert the angle twice pi by 3 in degree measurement. It is given as in the radian measurement. So in place of r, if we put twice pi by 3, we will get the value of d as 120 degree after simplification. So in this way, we can find out the other measurement. Next one is our trigonometric function. Achha. So before we go to the trigonometric function, we all know about the trigonometric ratios. That is here, this, what are they? They are sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta. Now you see here, what is your sin? Sin theta, the sin theta, cos theta, these are all trigonometric ratios. But what is your sin, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec? These are nothing but the functions. Right? These are nothing but the function. It is your sin of theta. Simply we can call this is a sin theta. Now let's see in another way. If we draw an unit circle means radius 1, with centered at O. Now, at the point O, if we draw two perpendicular lines passing through the point O, and let us choose one as X axis, another as Y axis, right? Now you see here, this circle cuts the X axis at the point A and A dash, and B, Y axis at the point B and B dash. There, since it is the radius 1, or the length of OA is 1, therefore the coordinate of A is 1, 0 and coordinate of A dash is minus 1, 0. Similarly, the coordinate of B is 0, 1 and coordinate of B dash is 0, minus 1. If we rotate the line ray OA in the anticlockwise direction by making an angle theta, let OP be the position of that ray. Since P is a point in the Cartesian plane, so we can put the coordinates of P here. Let the coordinate of P is XY. That is, if we draw a perpendicular PM on OAX, then OM is nothing but your X and PM is nothing but your Y. So POM is nothing but your right angle triangle. So from this right angle triangle, we know that sin theta is nothing but your perpendicular by hypotenuse. That is your Y by 1. So Y is equal to sin theta. Similarly, cos theta is equal to your base by hypotenuse. That is your x by 1 is nothing but your cos theta. Now you see here, in place of P x y, for coordinates of the point, we can put here P in place of x, we can put cos theta in place of y, we can put here sin theta also. Similarly, your tan theta is nothing but your y by x, cos theta is nothing but your, cot theta is nothing but your x by y, cosec theta 1 by y, and sec theta is nothing but your 1 by x. Now, if we consider the radius of a circle as r unit instead of unit radius, that is, if we consider r in place of 1, therefore, from this triangle, we can say that our sin theta is equal to y by r and cos theta is equal to your x by r. Therefore, y can be written as r sin theta and x can be written as y, r cos theta. Next one is our sine of trigonometric ratios. Now you see here, sine of how we can find the, that is, in our earlier classes, HSLC classes, our teachers, we were told by our teachers that all are positive in the first quadrant, sine and cosec are positive in the second quadrant, tan and cot are positive in the third quadrant, and cot and sec are positive in the fourth quadrant. Right? Let's see how it comes. Now you see, if we consider a plane and if we divided the plane into four equal parts, then we know that each part is known as your quadrant. Now you see, in your first quadrant, if we move the anticlockwise direction, in your first quadrant, your x is always positive, y is positive, and your sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, sec theta, all are contains y as well as x, right? So here, since x and y are positive, therefore all trigonometric ratios will be positive. In your second quadrant, x is negative and y is positive. That is the functions which, that is the ratios which relates only y, will be positive. That is your sine and cosec are the only functions which relates with y only. Therefore, sine and cosec are positive, and in other functions, in our previous slide, we have seen that our function x is there in your other trigonometric ratios. That's why they are negative here. Now, in your third quadrant, x is negative, y is positive. That is, sine theta contains only y. That's why it is negative. Cosec theta also contains y, only y. Therefore, they are negative. Sec and cosec theta also contains x only. Therefore, they are negative. But your tan and cot theta contains both y and x. So by cancelling minus minus, we will get these two terms as a positive, that is tan and cot are positive in the third quadrant. Now come to the fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, x is positive, y is negative. That is the function ratios which contains x only, they are positive. That is your cos theta and sec theta are positive and others are negative. So we can, this rule is known as what? ASTC rule, all sine, tan and cos. Let us move to our next slide. Next topic is nothing but your domain. Now you see here, your sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec, cot, these are all functions. And we all know that when the question of function comes, there should be some domain of the function. Domains means the area where the function is defined. Now you see here, if we consider it for your better understanding, I am considering here an unit circle in this diagram. In your unit circle, right? In your unit circle, also we can consider the other circle also. In your, what is your, that is, what is your x? Here, x is nothing but your, earlier slides, we can say that sin theta is nothing but your x in case of a unit circle, and cos theta is nothing but your y in case of a unit circle, where x, p, x, y are the coordinates of any point on the arc. That is the point and this point comes by rotating the ray OX in the anticlockwise direction at an angle theta. Achha. Now you see here, here X is nothing but your real line. Y is nothing but your real line. That is X in all the points here, X is defined. And here Y is defined in all the real values of Y. That's why sin theta and cos theta are defined for all real values of theta. So the domain of sin theta and cos theta is nothing but your set of all real numbers. Now come to the tan and cot theta. Now you see here, tan theta is nothing but your y by x, sec theta is nothing but your y by x. That is, in the whenever you have to find the domain, we first of all we have to check about the denominator. That is where the terms is undefined. Now you see here, tan theta and sec theta will be undefined when x is 0, means when cos theta is 0. Cos theta means when x is 0. Then our function, these two ratios are undefined. Now, we all know that x is equal to 0 on what axis? Y axis. And your y axis, your angle is nothing but if we move the anticlockwise direction, when our angle at pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, we are on y axis. Or point should be on, terminal side should be on y axis. Now, if we move the clockwise direction, then in minus pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 5 pi, when our angle rotates, minus pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 5 pi by 2, we will get the terminal side as our y axis. So we can say that, our x will be 0 when theta is nothing but here plus minus 2, plus minus 3 pi by 2, plus minus 5 pi by 2, in that way it goes. Now if we consider the general value, we will get theta is equal to twice n plus 1 pi by 2, where n is nothing but your integer. So for these values of theta, your tan theta and cot theta remains undefined. So whenever we are to find the domain of these two ratios, we are to omit these parts from the set of real numbers, right? So the domain of tan theta and sec theta will be r minus theta, such that theta belongs to r and theta is equal to, that is we have to omit this angles from the set of real number. The theta is equal to twice n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to z, right? Now come to the next one, cot theta and cosec theta left. Now you see here, cos theta and cosec theta is undefined when sin theta is equal to 0, because cot theta in the denominator of cot theta and cosec theta, sin theta is there. So when sin theta is 0, here these two ratios becomes undefined. These two functions, cot and cosec, becomes undefined. Sin theta equal to 0 means x is equal to 0, y equal to 0. Y equal to 0 and what axis? X axis. And your x axis, your angle is nothing but your 0. Then if we move anticlockwise direction, 0 pi, twice pi, 3 pi, in that way it goes. If we move on the clockwise direction, it will come from 0, minus pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, in that way it goes. Now if we find the general values of theta, we will get theta is equal to n pi, where n is an integer. So these are the values of theta where cot theta and cosec theta are undefined. So whenever we find the domain of cot theta and cosec theta, we have to omit those values of theta where they are undefined. So this is your r minus theta, such that theta belongs to r and theta is equal to n pi, where n is an integer. I hope you got these things. That is what is, how can you find the domain of these trigonometric functions. In your next video, we will go for the range of these trigonometric functions. I hope it's clear to you. Yes. Thank you, everybody.